If you smoke a pack and a half a day, the time spent on smoking and handling ashtrays, cigarettes, and lighters totals about 4 hours every day. There are any number of products on the market to help you stop smoking. Pills, filters, prescription products. Some work to help your next cigarette taste off. There's lots of literature. We're using the self-help guide from the Canadian Cancer Society, How to Be a Happy Ex-Smoker. Meet Murray Kelly. He's going to try to stop smoking on our quit day next week. Murray is 40. He works in the city, lives in the country with his wife, Heather.
My wife and I have just had a new baby boy, Clark. He's 11 weeks old, and from the day he was born, I wanted to quit. I'm not a big joiner of groups. I'm not a big go-out-there-and-get-involved type. I live in the river here, and I like it. And ever since I moved here, I wanted to shape my lifestyle up, get better health. And I'm not so afraid of dying from cigarettes as much as I want to live. I want to live healthy. I don't want him to swim in the side stream smoke. I don't want him to see me doing this constantly all the time. I hate smokes. I learned from that test that the pleasure is not really what I'm up to here. It's stimulation, tension management, and habit. And I really don't like them.
Preparation is important. Let's start to get conscious about smoking. Here's a quiz. Okay. When do you smoke?
How many cigarettes do you smoke in a day? 40. Do you smoke almost an equal number each day? Yes. Do you smoke more cigarettes in the afternoon than in the evening? The same number. Do you smoke more on the weekends than during the week? Less. How often do you smoke while talking on the phone? A million times. Frequently. Do you reach for a cigarette just because the pack is in sight? Yes. How often do you smoke when you're tense or angry? Often. Do you light up more often when you're relaxed than when you're working? Fewer when I'm relaxed. So there's the 8 questions answered.
Now that you know when you smoke, why not keep track of the cigarettes you do smoke and record your urges? That's when you feel like one, but don't light up. It helps to keep yourself conscious of your smoking, and it'll help cut down on your cigarettes, too. Cigarettes deliver nicotine plus 3,800 other chemicals. 50 of them are known to be carcinogenic in animals, or humans, or both. No wonder 85% of us want to quit.
The reason I want to quit is more social at this point now. People I'm with don't smoke anymore. I feel embarrassed to smoke around a lot of people I know who don't smoke. At work, people don't smoke. Health, too. I feel I want to breathe easier. And it's more social than it is my health at this point, because it hasn't really affected my health that to any extent for me to be feel worried about it.
I guess the first part would be peer pressure and friends and all that to quit smoking, and putting pressure on. The second part would be expense. It's getting too expensive. And the third part would be health. I don't see any negative effects right now in health. However, I know they're there.
And my dog is coughing. And I think perhaps I'm responsible. The house is polluted. I just want to quit and make things sanitary again. Okay?
I have a constant cough. I'm only 20 years old, and I think about what my health is going to be like if I keep smoking and never take the chance to quit. Also a lot of peer pressure from friends to quit, which is quite different from when I started.
Do you smoke to perk yourself up and give yourself a lift? Yes means you're a stimulation smoker. But you can be stimulated without using nicotine. Most people are. Do you find smoking relaxing and pleasant? Yes means you're a pleasure smoker. Cigarettes are a reward. When you stop smoking, there'll be bigger and better rewards. Do you sometimes get a growing hunger for a cigarette? Yes means you're addicted to nicotine. Do you like lighting up, playing with the cigarette, and watching the smoke? When you stop smoking, there'll be dozens of things you can do to keep your hands busy. Do you light up when your nerves are on edge or when you're worried? Yes means you smoke for relaxation. Surprisingly, non-smokers are really calmer people. Have you found one of your cigarettes burning in the ashtray right after lighting up a new one? That's a habit, and not hard to break. Start listing each cigarette you smoke. Some of us may say yes to two or even five of these questions. There are many kinds of smokers. Meet Susan Cullen. She's a woman in her mid-20s, lives and works in the city. We'll be following her as she tries to quit smoking.
I don't like the thought of smoking the rest of my life, having a cigarette in my hand, hanging out of my mouth. It's just, I don't like it. It doesn't feel good, and I don't really enjoy it.
Cigarettes aren't pure tobacco. The manufacturer's list of ingredients that cigarettes could contain include rum, whiskey, shellac, volcanic ash, vinegar, and deer tongue. There's no one way to quit smoking. Hypnotism can subliminally short-circuit your desire to smoke. It's a technique that uses the power of suggestion. According to its practitioners, acupuncture can alter the sensation in your respiratory system. It can actually change the taste of cigarettes. Smoking after acupuncture doesn't give you the same lift. The pleasure and gratification is gone. One way to quit is to go to a smoking cessation clinic. People sign up, pay up, and take the course with the group. There are elements of peer pressure, the buddy system, and lots of expert advice for support. At the same time, there's the opportunity to talk about smoking cessation in group therapy.
Well, it's a shame that you're the only nicotine junkie around, eh?
And the media can help you stop smoking. These health promotion posters from the mid-60s had an effect. And sometimes it can be as simple as a word from the doctor. Here's Dr. Don Weigel.
Why do people smoke, or why do people keep smoking? Certainly people who already smoke have a major addiction. Nicotine is among the most addicting chemicals known to man. You have to smoke roughly one cigarette every 30 minutes to keep your blood level of nicotine at a comfortable level. So this is number one for the already addicted or habitual smoker. For young people who have not yet started to smoke, the story is more complicated. Factors such as advertising, role models, peer pressure all come into play. But that's an area that we don't really understand well enough, because if we did, people wouldn't start to smoke.
Hypnotism, acupuncture, and clinics are all different. The one thing they have in common is they all take willpower. The most popular way to quit is through self-help. And the most successful technique is to go cold turkey. Both Murray Kelly and Susan Cullen will be doing just that on Quit Day. But this week, they're preparing themselves. No one can convince you to stop smoking if you don't want to. You have to make the commitment. Keep track of your smoking. Practice missing a cigarette. Try tapering down a bit.